The claims made by the Saint Kitts Prime Minister about his country's economic turnaround wasn't just political chest beating. The International Monetary Fund itself has lauded what it says are substantial strides made using the country's homegrown economic programs to improve its economic fortunes. As the Prime Minister explained on Sunday, taking St. Kitts' national debt from 200% to 85% was no easy feat and required public acceptance of uncomfortable and unpopular government policies. That same sort of discipline and sacrifice, he said, is needed from the St. Lucian electorate.
The road that the government and people of St. Kitts and Nevis have walked together to get to where we are today was not easy. There were many difficult choices that had to be made, and the levels of concern were very real. But at the end of the day, the government and the people, we stuck together, and our discipline has been rewarded.
One of those unpopular policies was the implementation of the value-added tax, or VAT. But according to Prime Minister Douglas, despite the initial discomfort with the policy, even Kitticians have to acknowledge the role that VAT has played in stabilizing the territory's finances and economy. The Minister for Sustainable Development, in responding to Dr. Douglas's advice, pointed out that St. Lucia was already well on the way to implementing many of the same policies.
He's had to deal with a weak economy in a global economic crisis and worrying levels of public debt and a very limited fiscal space. And we heard the Prime Minister of St. Kitts and Nevis, the Right Honourable Dr. Denzil Douglas, tell you of the challenges and the things that need to be done. And when I was sitting at the back there, next to Harold Dalsor, next to Emma Hippolyte, what they were saying to me is that a lot of the things that Dr. Douglas is saying that we need to do, we have already started doing in St. Lucia. And the message that he put forward, which is the important one, is you must be patient. You must trust your government and you must trust your Prime Minister to know that he is doing the right thing for our country.
Prime Minister Dr. Kenny Anthony, who, like his Kittician counterpart, is hoping to be returned to office at the next poll, says the Labour Party's successes in the last 3 years cannot be discounted or denied, despite the harsh criticisms of his government's management of the economy.
Sometimes we are hard on ourselves. So taken in by the criticisms of our detractors that we fail to recognize our accomplishments. We are in danger of becoming apologists for our success.
Faced with the task of rebuilding a weak economy in the midst of a global financial crisis, worrying levels of public debt and high unemployment, the SLP has given itself a passing grade for its accomplishments in what it says was a very limited fiscal space. For the DBS News World, Kendal Burton reporting.